One friend asks, "Is there really exists a division of the head and the heart?" The head and the heart are one. The human mind has a tendency to divide everything, to see everything fragmented. Since the mind itself has its limitation, it cannot conceive the unlimited. It cannot enter into the mystery of limitlessness, and so it sees and understands all things in bits and pieces. But that is not the case. Nothing is actually fragmented. Everything exists in totality. Now you have doubts that, whereas I say the mind and the heart function in unison, but when you observe in the world, they do not seem to be working that way. You can see people who are heart-oriented and you find them working emotionally without entering into logic. Then you can see people who function mainly through their mind. They think and act, ignoring the feelings. The two seem to be working in entirely different directions. Those you consider as heart-oriented, looking at their external behavior as being emotional or caring nature, are not necessarily what they appear to be. As I have always said, that emotionalism is a disease. These are self-centered people. They only consider themselves as important. And then there are people who appear to be civilized, as they have trained themselves with good mannerisms. But that may again be superficial. Inside, their intentions may not be good. They may carry jealousy, hate, and so many negative things inside them. Then there are people who may not be very polished, may appear to be too direct to the level of rudeness, yet they could have transparency and a clear heart. We all know that many saints treat you externally with undignified behavior and foul language. They don't bother too much about sophistication or image, but that does not disqualify them from their state of love and compassion. They don't need labels and certificates from anyone. You cannot come to any conclusion with what one portrays. Similarly, people coming out with fine thoughts, having profound thinking, great ideas, and innovative people, you name them as intellectuals. But you often disassociate them with feelings. That is not the truth. All this division and classification has caused great damage to the society. When thought is isolated from the heart, it is at the root of all wars. And when the heart is not based on clear thinking, then also it creates all foolishness in the name of feelings, and that too results in friction in the society. For a smooth coexistence and outer and inner prosperity, the thoughts and the feelings go hand in hand, but the limited mind is not able to see it. If you observe, you will see for yourself that it is not the way we think it to be. The heart and the head do go together. They are a unified field. Can any feeling be devoid of thought? It is the richness of the feeling that gives rise to the beauty in the thought. It is love, it is compassion that translates into thoughts of geniuses. Whatever luxury we are living in, the modern lifestyles making life easy, are all results of beautiful ideas and brain waves and researches arising out of extraordinary thoughts from a loving and compassionate heart. Likewise, can the thought be devoid of feeling? Is not all wisdom translated into the heart as love? Is thought not part of wisdom? No wonder so much attraction towards knowledge, for knowledge throws one into bliss. Then thoughts result in such action which are expressions of love. So how can you separate the two? When we talk about the head and the heart, we are not talking about the biological or physiological placement and functioning of these organs of brain and heart. Rather, we are talking about the balance and harmony in our energy fields. The yoga and the tantra say that we have 7 energy receiving points in our body known as the chakras. Having their unique qualities and features, the heart chakra is in the middle with 3 energy chakras above and the 3 below it. It is the balancing point where energies of all 7 chakras are balanced and in harmony. All these energies work as a unified field at the heart chakra. If the above chakras are more activated or the lower chakras are more activated, then this harmony is disturbed and may prove to be dangerous and fatal. The purpose of all sadhana is to reach this harmony. The heart and the head are together. We don't have to create it. It is already there. It is existential. And we need to see it and be established in it. And then all is one expansion of love felt within as bliss and outside as compassion.